mercy and compassion. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are always ready to forgive our sin. Christ, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, we turn to you in sorrow, asking for forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who opened wide the gates of the heavenly kingdom to those reborn of water and the Holy Spirit, pour out on your servants an increase of the grace you have bestowed, that, having been plunged or purged of all sin, they may lack nothing that in your kindness you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen said to the people, the elders and the scribes, "You stiff-necked people, uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always oppose the Holy Spirit. You are just like your ancestors. Which of the prophets did your ancestors not persecute? They put to death those who foretold the coming of the Righteous One, whose betrayers and murderers you have now become. You received the law as transmitted by angels, but you did not observe it." When they heard this, they were infuriated. They ground their teeth at Stephen. But Stephen, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked up intently to heaven and saw the glory of God. And he saw Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And Stephen said, "Behold, I see the heavens opened and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they all cried out in a loud voice, covered their ears, and rushed upon Stephen together. They threw him out of their city, began to stone him, and witnesses laid down their cloaks at the feet of a young man named Saul. As they were stoning Stephen, he called out, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he fell to his knees and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." And when he said this, he fell asleep. Now Saul was consenting to his execution. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. You are my rock and my fortress. For your name's sake, you will lead and guide me.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands, I commend my spirit. You will redeem me, O Lord, O faithful God. My trust is in the Lord. I will rejoice and be glad of your mercy.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Let your face shine upon your servants. Save me in your kindness. You hide them in the shelter of your presence from the plottings of people.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
The crowd said to Jesus, "What sign can you do that we may see and believe in you? What can you do? Our ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat." So Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." So they said to Jesus, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. Manna, bread, those two words are key to today's scripture reading, as well as also will be in the next days ahead for the gospel reading. Starting today until the end of the week are from chapter 6 of John's Gospel. Jesus' own teaching, his discourse about the bread of life. As I've said different times before here, it's helpful to see the, or get the background and the setting of a particular scripture passage, and that it always helps us then to understand the present text. So as we look at today's gospel, what preceded it is in the first 15 verses of John's, chapter 6 of John's gospel, we have the story, not the story, but the episode of Jesus multiplying the 5 loaves and the 2 fish to feed that big crowd of people that had followed him for some time and were hungry, and also too, some of them having come distance, it had been very difficult for them to return back home without having provisions to do so. So he multiplied those 5 loaves and 2 fish and then directed his apostles to even to gather up the leftovers as well, showing how he can provide abundance to feed people. Then that night, he stayed behind temporarily while the others crossed the sea by boat. But then during the night, Jesus came walking on the waters across the Sea of Galilee. So Jesus is preparing his hearers for his teaching. He tries to elevate their minds about material or physical bread to heavenly bread, which gives eternal life. And then secondly, he establishes his discourse's basic principle, work to obtain the bread that lasts for eternal life. And he's referring then to the bread that he provides. And as we near the end of today's gospel, he says, "I am the bread of life." And he introduces something that shortly before today's passage, when the people ask, "Well, what are the works of God that God wants us to do?" Perhaps expecting that Jesus would say, "Make God perform some difficult task, make a pilgrimage to some holy place or that." And he says, "The work that the Father asks of you is believe in the one God sent." And that brings us into today's gospel. A crowd of people there are suspecting Jesus is claiming to be someone greater than Moses, for they cite the fact that when their ancestors were wandering in the wilderness on the way to the promised land, God provided, or manna was provided for them, and they accredited Moses for obtaining that for them in some about to make some important statement or to give some important teaching. And he says, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. The word true there doesn't mean to indicate that the manna was not real food for them. It was, because it provided their bodily nourishment for those years in the wilderness. But that it was not the complete bread that the Father would give them as he does in sending his Son Jesus into the world as the bread of life. So the listeners then challenge and get the idea that Jesus is claiming to be someone even greater than Moses. And so they challenge him to do something even more wonderful than what Moses had done. And Jesus then tries to redirect their attention from what God did in the past to God's action in the present. And Jesus is saying, God is now providing bread from heaven, which gives life to the whole world. So when they hear that, life, they jump at the idea and give us, sir, give us this bread, give us this bread always. And that's when Jesus then says, I am the bread of life. So that is what our Lord says here, that whoever comes to me will never hunger, whoever believes in me will never thirst. And so that's what our God, loving God, continues to do for us. And we continue now with our, well, tomorrow gospel continues with that discourse of Jesus, but let us now continue with our celebration of the bread of life that Jesus provides for us. Our faith tells us that God does, God promises, and so we turn now to our faith in God that He will hear our petitions.
For the church, as the body of Christ in the world, may God bless her with purity and unity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our elected leaders, may God grant them fortitude to rise above all that divides them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering religious or ethnic persecution, may God protect them from all harm and prejudice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those most affected by coronavirus, suffering its symptoms, having lost their life, those who mourn for loved ones who have perished, as well as the many people who are so dedicated to stopping the spread of this pandemic throughout our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, May they find a place in heaven at the eternal banquet of the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, we know that you provide for our needs, and we thank you, Lord, for giving us the bread of life to nourish us spiritually as well. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
My sister and brother, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, these offerings of your exalted church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gift we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to praise you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me.
Oh, join me in this prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
With kindness upon your people, O